Today we are going to read about North America, and North America is one of the continents, and its name is named after an Italian explorer, and that explorer name was Amerigo Vespucci. He reached this continent in 1507 CE, but in reality the main discoverer is the Christopher Columbus, who reached this continent in 1492. So in 15th century this continent was discovered. Although many adventurous seamen visited America, like Norsemen and Vikings, they visited in early 986 CE, but their visit was forgotten. So finally, the discovery of America, that is the New World, was accepted universally by everyone that it was discovered by Christopher Columbus in 1492. Okay, then what happened? North America together with South America is known as the New World because they were discovered recently in the 15th century. So North America with South America is known as the New World. And why it is known as New World? Because they were discovered recently in the 15th century. Latitudinal extent of North America is 7 degree north to 84 degree north, and longitudinal extent is 20 degree west degree to 175 degree west. Highest point in North America is Mount McKinley in Alaska, and lowest point is Death Valley in California. You should know this. Then location, North America lies in the north, northern and the western hemisphere of the world, and it is somewhat triangular in shape, and it is surrounded by Arctic Ocean in the north and the Atlantic Ocean in the east and the Pacific Ocean in the west. Okay, and it is joining South America with North America with Isthmus of Panama. What is Isthmus? Isthmus is a narrow stretch of land which is joining North America and the South America. So its name is Isthmus of Panama. Then in the northwest, Bering Strait is there, which is separating Asia from North America. Then latitude and longitude we have already read. Then there is a 100 degree west longitude is there, which is very important because it passes from the center of North America. North America comprises of many countries, United States of America, Canada, Mexico, etc. Okay, and the very important latitude, that is Tropic of Cancer, is passing through the Mexico, which is also a very large country in North America. If we move forward south of Tropic of Cancer, the continent is becoming very narrow, and few countries they form the Central America, like Panama, El Salvador, Costa Rica. If you will look in the Caribbean Sea, so there is so many islands are there, which is known as the West Indies. And this West Indies include Cuba, Jamaica, Dominican Republic, Haiti, Puerto Rico, and few other islands are there. So now if you move to the north, northern side, Baffin Island is there, Victoria Island is there, Ellesmere Island is there, which is snow covered. Then Greenland is there. Greenland, which is geographically a part of North America, actually belongs to Denmark. And remember one more thing, Greenland is the largest island in the world. Then next we have Newfoundland, which is another island of the northeast coast of North America, and it is very important for fishing. Okay, it is important for fishing because so many varieties of fishes are found here, so that's why it is important area. Then if you move towards the north of North America, you will see Aleutian Island, which is spreading along the northwest coast of North America, and it looks like a chain between the continents of Asia and North America.